Welcome back to another collaboration video with Sarah's Nail Secrets in our Christmas series on this channel. So today's video is a current nail favorites video. I started filming these again monthly. I think I only did two, but my plan was to do one every single month, and I didn't do October's or November because you guys know how November went for me. So we thought it'd be fun to kind of sit down and do some of our favorite products that have just stood out in the last few months. And it'll be really interesting to see what Sarah's favorite products are, because I don't know if she's really done favorites videos. So I'm really looking forward to kind of checking out what have been her favorite things in the nail studio. So my video is not just nail art. There's brushes, there's things for content creation. There's just some like standout products that I've really been enjoying for the month of October, because I'm going to include my October favorites in this, and then like leading up until now too. So let's dive in and get started. So first up, these little pads of paper. I think all of these ones were from Hobby Lobby when I went to the States like years ago, probably like 4 years ago. They do sell these ones, like small paper pads like this, at the dollar stores. Michaels has them. Michaels comes out with the seasonal ones that are just a little bit smaller. And what I like about these obviously is the size of them. So these actually worked really well for my Halloween compilation video because I had two cameras going, and so I could focus one camera on the little small paper pads just sitting right beside me and do my little artwork over there, and then move over to the big paper pads over here, where sometimes I need them to be like a little bit more zoomed out. So I really like the size of paper pad. It's been on my list to kind of share with you guys that this has been a really good product for me, content creation. So I just wanted to quickly mention them. I do have a couple different ones, like this floral one's one of my favorites. I have this one in a big pad too, because I just love it. But these are so old, so I doubt you can even get these specific ones anymore. But like I said, Michaels does have small paper pads like this. They're great if you're just doing any sort of zoomed in shots and you don't need like the whole big paper pad that I typically use. So I've been really liking those. Another thing that has been really working out well for me for content creation are these little dishes. So these are the snowflake ones that I picked up in my Christmas haul. And then I also have these floral dishes, and both of these are just from HomeSense. And I know I've seen like seashell ones and different kind of ones there too, but I really like these when I'm working to just kind of keep stuff in. When I do nail art on people, I tend to use a ton of products and it gets like all over my desk. But when I'm creating content, it's like 10 times worse. So having somewhere to kind of throw things in as I'm working has just been functioning so well. For example, if I'm doing like stamping or something, I will keep one of these with like all of my lids and everything in it, so they're just here and not all over my desk. Or like you can see here, when I did our compilation video, I just put the tips in here after I was done filming them. And then this one's like crazy, but this one is full of all of the colors that I've swatched in the last couple of months. And truthfully, I'm not entirely sure what I want to do with these, which is why they have just kind of stayed in here. Little dishes have just really been coming in handy for content creation, so I just kind of wanted to mention them. And I mean, obviously I needed some festive ones, but I have, well, my cats broke one of them. But these little palette holders, this is from Glitter Mix Canada. I'm really, really liking these. I like that they are like a hard acrylic. But I do like mixing tiles or tiles or anything for filming content stuff as well. And these are working really, really well. I also really like the size of them. I like the gold detailing, and I like that it's neutral. As much as I love color and showcasing color and stuff, when I'm using products like this in my videos, I want it to just be neutral, so it just kind of blends in with the background. I don't want it to like take over my video. So I'm really, really liking this little palette thing. Another thing, this I know for sure was on my list to share with you guys. These are the Opry Gel X Tips, more specifically the square one. I love the square one for filming videos. You guys know I use these little tips in my little fingers. This is the square one, and I just really like how it fits the Red Iguana fingers. Some of the other ones that I've used that are square or coffin from different brands, I just don't love as much as this one. Like this one just fits really nice in the side. It just It looks really good. I'm a big fan of how these ones lay because they are super, super arched. And for the fingers, if you guys are wondering, number 4 from Aubrey fits the best. And then I also have the long coffin ones, which I keep in one of these dishes sitting off to the side here. And I also equally really like how this one looks in the red iguana fingers too. Again, it fits really nice down the sidewall and it just looks really good. I have the ugly duckling ones in this shape and I don't love them as much for some reason. They just don't seem to fit the red iguana fingers as nice as the Aubrey ones do in this specific shape. The almond ones from Ugly Duckling I really like. And number 2 from Ugly Duckling fits good. But you'll notice like right off the bat, they're not quite as arched, so they don't fit as well on the sidewalls. Like they don't bevel up as much as the Aubrey ones do, which is why I'm finding that I'm gravitating towards using these for my compilation videos as well. But I do really like the Ugly Duckling ones. It's just for these particular shapes, I prefer the Aubrey ones. So moving on to some tools that I've really been liking. These little lipstick wands, I got these on Amazon. I really like these for when I am doing any sort of chrome. Sometimes I get chrome kind of on the nail here. And these little lipstick ones, I just dip in a little bit of acetone, wipe them up so they're not like sopping wet, and then I can clean up around the nail wherever I need to get that chrome off. I was using Q-tips, but I just find because they're a little bit bigger and a little bit more fuzzy that they kind of just get in the way. And then I was finding these micro swabs were just like too small to really clean off where I wanted it to. So when I was looking on Amazon just to see if I could find something that would work, these little lipstick wands came up and I like the pointed head of them because I can get like right around where I want to clean up any sort of, mostly it's chrome pigments when I'm stamping that kind of gets on the nail, and it just works really, really well. So I'm a big, big fan of these. And then also these little makeup wands, what do they call these? Eyeshadow wands. I've been using for chrome application. When I am putting chrome on my stamper, I will just take like a little bit of the chrome and rub it all over the stamping head, and these are just working so well for them. And I can also get 4 uses out of it because there's 4 different heads on them. So I just find that this goes a little bit further for me than using like a cosmetic sponge and such. We were just kind of talking about chrome, so why not just stay on that track? So this little eyeshadow chrome thing I got from Glitter Mix Canada. You guys would have saw it in my haul video. I also used it in my compilation video for Christmas, for the Christmas compilations, and I love it. It just works so well. It is so, so concentrated. I'm pretty sure it was the Nativity nail that I used them on. And I just found it to be super, super concentrated. It transferred really nice. It cleaned off really nice. A little bit went a long way with it. And I also like that it's like a pressed powder instead of like a messy chrome, because I just find that it just didn't make as much mess. So I'm definitely gonna have to see if she has any more of these, because if she has different colors of these, I think they would work for fantastic for sticky polish stamping. I'm really, really impressed with this little thing here. So I wanted to share it with you. Sticking on the chrome. Oh my gosh, chrome wagon. These are from Wildflowers and they came in a pack of, I wanna say 8, but I think I only grabbed 6 of them here. Maybe they only came in 6. Wildflowers sugar pack. And I mentioned this in my Christmas recommendations from Creative Beauty, but at that time of recommending it, I hadn't actually used these yet. I just thought they would be a good little Christmas or winter set, so something to kind of look into. But now that I've used these are great. I particularly love these little sugar mixes. So this is Fairy Dust. Again, you guys would have saw it in my Christmas compilations video. It's a really dense powder and it works really well in combination with sticky polish stamping. And then this one here, I know I used this one in that video too. And this is Lily Pond. And again, it's just nice and dense and it's got some pink and green kind of look to it as well. So I like that this particular pack has not only chromes in it, but they have like finer glitters. And then you have this Lily Pond glitter that's a little bit more chunky too. So I was just really impressed with using it. I love that they are mostly white or kind of sheer products as well, because then when you're layering them over top of other colors, you're not gonna lose your base color underneath. I love products like that that just make your existing products go a little bit further, and that's exactly what I think this little set is. So I was really impressed with it when I was using it for that video. I used it so much in my compilations video, the first Christmas compilations that Sarah and I did, that I was like, gosh, like this is just such a great set. Speaking of sugar powders, another one that I wanted to talk about is this one from Glitter Bells, and it is called Fairy Dust. And I really like this one too because it's got like a gold to it, a gold sheen. And the Glitter Bells Loose Glitters, they are a very large pack. So 15 grams, so it's a very large container. I just wanted one really nice sugar powder that you would just use all season long. This would probably be a good one to look into because you get so much in it. It would do you for such a long time for Christmas nail art, winter nail art. You can also mix these glitters in with gel or acrylic. Again, another versatile product that can make your other products in your collection go a little bit further. So I really like that. Couple other glitters that I just wanted to share briefly that have stood out to me lately, again from Glitter Bells. This one here is silver. I love this. I know I mentioned it in my haul video, but I love that this is just a plain silver glitter mix. There's no holographic to it. There's three different sizes of glitter. You have your fine, your medium, and your chunky glitter in here, all in one, and all silver. I just find it so hard to find all silver glitter mixes that are not holographic, and Glitter Bells has one. So I think that that is a great kind of staple product, not just for winter or Christmas, but like all year round. And then the last glitter, this is just so beautiful. It is called Glow, and it is like your perfect holographic rose gold glitter. It is just so stunning. I absolutely love it. Would be fantastic for New Year's nails. Another good staple product that's neutral, so it would go with any other color that you're pairing it with. I just think you'd get a ton of use out of this one as well. So I just wanted to mention those ones quickly. These kind of pair with our sticky polish, but these two foil kits. So we have this one here. This one is from the Daily Charm Ultimate Metallics Nail Foil Kit from Creative Beauty, and I love this. I love the colors in this because they are all metallics. So if you're gonna use any sort of chrome product consistently or often, you're gonna reach for your metallics more than any others in your collection. And I love that we have a kit here that combines all of that together. So we have, I like this set because not only do we have our flat metallics that are matte, we also have some holographic metallics, and then we have our just basic shiny metallics in it too. I just think that this is such a great set, and one that if you were looking to just get one foil set. And then the other foil set that I really like that is completely different from that, but I also think is a good staple, especially with the Clear Jelly Sticky Polish, is this little one from Clear Jelly Stamper. It is their number 5 foil set. And I love this one because it is all white again. So similar to the Wildflowers Sugar set, this is a set that you'll get a lot of use out of because when you stamp with it over top of any other color, you're not gonna lose the color that's underneath it. So I did feature this in a tutorial video recently, and I will try to remember which one it is and leave it linked up top here. I like how we have just some plain white, we have some patterned white, we had some marble white, but also like some fun patterns in here. So I just think that this is a great one for pairing with the Clear Jelly Stamper Sticky Polish, which I have featured so much lately in favorites videos on my channel. It's just my favorite way to stamp right now. I just love the CJS Sticky Polish. So having some foils and some chromes that kind of pair nicely with it, I'm really enjoying. Well, let's talk about polish. So this stamping polish is quickly becoming one of my favorites. It is number 93. And it is a milky white stamping polish. So it's kind of like a sheer white stamping polish. I absolutely love this. I'm so glad that Clear Jelly Stamper came out with it. It pairs nicely with just like your plain bright white. So if you stamp this down first with their layered stamping and then you outline in a bright white, it just gives such a soft look to your stamping. It's fantastic for lace stamping. It's great for snowflake stamping to just have a couple of different shades of white when you're doing your stamping too. It is just such a fantastic product, and because I have been doing more snowflake nails and snowflake nail art lately, this product I've been reaching for more, and I just have more of an appreciation for it. Let's talk about Coco & Claire. We have one product from them that I love, and I discovered it in my collection when I was filming the first compilation video because I was looking for a light pink, but I didn't want like a bright light pink. I wanted something a little bit rosy, and this color meets my needs for it. So this is from Coco & Claire number 181, and it is called Smoky Rose. And it is just a beautiful kind of muted rose color. It's so pretty. It's like 1000% going on my nails at some point. I love how it's muted. I love how it's not bright. I love how it has like a rosy tinge to it. It pair really nicely with some of those rosy other colors such as Rosy Posy from Light Elegance. It'd be great for floral nails, great for snowflake nails, which is how I think I'm going to wear it. But it is just so beautiful. And as soon as I opened it, I was like, why have I not been wearing this on my nails? This is just such a stunning color. Okay, so from Coco and Claire, these are brand new products. I have not featured them on my channel yet. I will be doing some sort of video for them. I just haven't quite figured out what I want to do for them yet. They came out with some new base gels. And then we also have some shiny top glosses, which I am so pumped about. These base products you would use in a similar way to how you would use their strong product, which you guys know I love Coco and Claire's strong. It's kind of like a builder in a bottle type of product. And these are just like it, but they have some like colors to them as well. So first up we have this one. Like I said, I'm gonna do a different video on these, so I'm not gonna dive too much into these. But this is Epiphany. So it is like a blue kind of chunkier glitter. This would be great for snowflake nails. We have this one here, which is Ethereal, and it is like a milky white with some glitters in it. 247, it is called Blissful Solitude, and it has like a pink look to it. And then this one, I'm so excited about. This one is number 250, and it is called May, and it is your milky white. Your milky white base, which I know many people would be excited about. And then we have 248, which is called Cali, and it is a little bit more peachy toned. Product here, which is 249, and it is called Willow. And it's just like more of a pink. Now that I'm thinking about it, I use these on my white French white nails that I was wearing for my Halloween compilation video. I don't know if there's other videos with it, but this was the pink base that I was using for it. So I have used these. Somebody had asked me if I'd used these before, and I'm like, no, not yet. I 1000% have used these. It held very well, held very similar to how they're strong holds as well. So then in addition to that, we also have their three top glosses. These I am pumped for. If you guys have been here for a bit, you've seen me mention the Magic Gel, tack-free top coats, their shimmer ones. So this is kind of the same idea as that. This is number 5, Mindful Magic, and it has like an iridescent look to it. And I have briefly just put these over top of like a swatch stick, and they do cure tack-free, which I love. This is Glitz, and it just has a really fine kind of greenish blue glitter to it. And then the last one is Wild Indigo, and it's got a little bit of an iridescent kind of purple look to it. So I am really excited about these. I hope that we see more top gloss shades specifically from them, because I would love to see like a gold one. But I wanted to share these because they are a new launch, but I know, I 1000% know that these top glosses for sure are going to end up being a staple of mine and a favorite. So, okay, the last few things that I want to talk about are just some watercolor favorites. I don't know if I've ever really talked about these before. These are the Soft Landings little towels. Truthfully, you guys, I don't even know where you can get these from anymore. So if you guys know, comment below and let me know. I have a few packs, and I really only ever use them for watercolor, so they're lasting me a while, but I would love to know where I can get more when I run out. I love the size of these for watercolor. So I usually, you guys have probably noticed, if I'm doing watercolor painting, I usually have a towel kind of off to the side to wipe my brush on. That way I can pull water out of it if I have too much water in, or if I have too much color in. I just have a little cloth sitting right beside me to do that. And these work great because they are 100% lint-free. I love the size of them, love the shape of them, but they absorb really well too. So if you guys ever see me doing watercolor, you more than likely see this in the video. So that's a favorite because I was doing some watercolor with the compilation videos. And then these watercolor palettes here. These are very inexpensive watercolor palettes that you can get from Michaels. They are meant for just like kids crafts and stuff, but they 100% work for watercolor on nails. They are just not as pigmented and will not show up as bright, and are harder to blend than the Prima watercolors that I have featured on this channel multiple times. But for the Christmas compilation video, I did not want watercolors that were super bright because I wanted them to be really toned down. So I used this and it really just sparked how much I really enjoy using this palette, but just keep in mind it does not blend very well. So if you're wanting to sheer out colors and stuff, you're gonna have to work a little bit harder to get them a little bit more sheer than you would with the more expensive Prima watercolor paints. So it's a really good array of different colors. I like that there's like a bigger kind of palette for you working with them too. I like that there's some good neutrals in here as well. It's just a really nice, well-rounded, staple kind of palette. And then they also have this one. This is a pearl one, and I like this. It is just not good quality. So this one is definitely difficult to blend out. It's also really sheer, so I like using it kind of paired over top of different watercolors just to give like a pearl effect to it, but it is really cool. And I do tend to reach for it a little bit more in the winter time because I want some of those pearl looking colors to go with my winter design. So I did want to mention those. And then a couple watercolor brushes lately. No, one watercolor brush and then another brush. There's no name for it. It's an inexpensive brush that I got from Can West years ago, but it works really well for watercoloring. I don't know what it is about the head of this because it's not like it's got a big belly and a fine tip on it, but I just find it works really, really well for watercolor. So if I can find this brush on like Amazon or something, I'll leave it linked in the description box below, but I tend to reach for it quite a bit if I'm stamping and then watercolor painting inside of it because it just really works well for it. And then this brush here was a discovery during that compilation video, and I loved using it, like instantly loved using it. So this is, it is their #2 Magic Brush Calligraphy Art Brush. You can see here that it's got kind of like a bigger belly, and then it goes to a super, super fine tip. So when I was coloring in the gnome nail, I wanted my gnome to be shiny and I wanted the background to be matte. So I grabbed this brush just on a whim just to see how it would work. It worked fantastic for getting the top gloss where I wanted it because of this head right on here. So if you're gonna do like any sort of kind of filling in, it just worked really well to get that product where I want it but not go outside the line because of the fine point of the head on it. So I know that's not what this brush was designed for, but it just worked so well for me that I was like, hey, this is going to be my new top gloss brush now for when I need to top gloss different outlines or anything. It just worked really, really well. I was super, super impressed with this brush when I was using it. I think that's it from all my current favorites. I found some pretty good stuff to share with you guys. There's been some really good products launching from different companies lately, so I can't wait to use them more in this Christmas series for you. And I hope to have a 2020 nail favorites video for you guys again this year. So I will be sharing like a collective group of products that have really stood out to me this year. Fingers crossed. But make sure that you guys head on over to Sarah's channel and see what her current favorite nail products are. Make sure you're following me on all my social media, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!